The Ben Davis and Kelly K Show podcast on demand.
Every year, this is some of my favorite moments on the radio, is when we can hear your stories of the unexplained, of the supernatural, of the spooky, as horror.
They're my favorite because they're not happening to me
yet. You just moved into a new house, Kelly. Yet.
I did. Okay.
Yet.
Okay.
Kimberly texts in and says, a family friend of ours had a plumber come to her house. He was working under the kitchen sink. She was talking to the plumber, and her son kept tapping her on the leg and asking if she could play with the little boy. She said, there's no little boy there. The plumber heard her and then went on to say that he lost his son at an early age.
Oh my God.
And her kid was not the only child to see his son with him on the job.
Oh my God, I have chills all through my body. Like, his little son follows him around?
I can't with that.
Oh
stuff.
My gosh!
Yeah.
Oh, wow, 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 wow.
Mm-hmm. Nancy writes in and says, when my daughter was 4. Man, what is it with kids?
See, they listen, because there's like no filter. They're very, you know, they can see all that stuff. They're very open to it.
Yeah, that's what they say. I don't know who they are, but they say that kids and animals are very susceptible to the supernatural.
Yes.
Nancy writes in, when my daughter was 4, she told me that my mother-in-law, who had passed away, would come sit at the foot of her bed and talk to her. And
oh, wow.
She said it like it was no big deal.
Yeah, just, you know, there's grandma. We have talks.
That is wild.
Now, see, okay, so here's my question. If it's like a family member that you, like, recognize, is that more comforting or is it still, like, kind of scary because they are no longer of this world?
I think it's more comforting, yes. Because if it's some stranger, you have no idea if this person's going to harm you or if this spirit's going to, like, be a poltergeist or whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah. It's just, I've never had an experience like that, but I don't know how I would react, even if it was, like, a family member. Now, see, my husband's had dreams of his biological mother, who has passed on, and he and his sister had similar dreams like the same night, and they in their dreams their mother was very young.
I will tell you, it would almost be better for me if it weren't a family member, because I don't need this family member of mine who has passed on to see me poop my pants right in front of them. You know what I mean?
You need to have a physical reaction. I know.